Hello everyone, welcome to this how-to video series on onboarding database management service for MySQL HeatWave DB systems in OCI. Let's understand how do we navigate to MySQL HeatWave systems from within OCI. Within the OCI console, under the Uber menu, you can go to databases and then you can select DB systems. I am in the context of a compartment which is my demo compartment. And I could see that there are two MySQL HeatWave systems or DB systems already created. They have been created and active. They have enabled for crash recovery. And the high availability options are currently not enabled along with the HeatWave cluster as well. Now let's start creating a DB system. You can click on the button Create DB System. This would walk you through a series of steps that you could follow. You can choose between a production system or a development or a test system. Production would set up a high availability DB system with the recommended defaults for production environment. And development or testing would take care of it from a development standpoint, which is a standalone DB system. You can choose the compartment where you want to provision your DB system, give it a name and an optional description. In case you want to switch to a standalone system for your production, you can choose them as well. But by default, the high availability option is chosen. Additionally, you might want to configure MySQL HeatWave. You can turn on the configuration for MySQL HeatWave if there is a requirement for running both OLTP and OLAP workloads from within the same database engine. Then you can provide your administrator credentials. In this demo video, I'm not going to walk you through the creation process as such. But the goal is to make you comfortable with how do we enable database management for MySQL HeatWave DB systems. I can provide a username and a password that would be useful for my administrative purposes. Then within the networking section, I can configure the virtual network. I can choose my VCN and also the subnet. Choose a compartment of my choice. I can also configure my preferred primary placement. The database systems are basically placed into availability domains from within the Oracle Cloud Infrastructure Data Center. You can choose your availability domain. And if you've chosen an availability domain, it would also prompt you to choose a fault domain. And if you do not select a fault domain, Oracle would choose a best placement for you. You can then configure the hardware. You can change the shape if there is a need and also configure the data storage. This would give you the indication in terms of how much IOPS and throughput to expect based on the configuration that you've already chosen. Backups are automatically configured with a backup retention period of 7 days. You can enable point-in-time recovery, which is also enabled by default. If you want, you could select a backup window. Now, under advanced options, you can move over to management and you could see that the database management is chosen by default. So as part of your provisioning flow, you can see that the database management is getting onboarded and it is chosen by default. Now let's go ahead and enable database management. You can have the capability to create it as is or maybe save as a stack for later purposes. So that concludes our demo of onboarding database management from within the provisioning flow of MySQL HeatWave DB systems. Thank you for watching.